Race fans, we thank you for coming out here to the Circle City on a beautiful Sunday afternoon. It's time to get up. Everybody stand up. Everybody get up. Come on. Get up. Get up. Get up. Get up. Wave lap time kicking off the McGonagall Legend Performance CRA Fall Brawl 2014 presented by Edco Welding. This is the Reynolds Body Shop 40 for the Vore's Welding CRA Late Model Sportsman Series powered by Jags. Cars, pace car, shuts the lights off. We'll head down pit road. It's in the hands of Jason Atkinson, the 7. Billy Van Meter in the 23 to lead this 29-car field to the green.
Off of turn 4, Atkinson looking for win number 15 in series history. Brings them in on the inside lane. The outside Van Meter. Stacking up back in the field as they make it to turn 1. A little bit of smoke from a car mid-pack.
Billy Van Meter around the outside. The number 23 machine heads down the backstretch for the first time this afternoon with the lead. Jason Atkinson riding second. Trey Craig third. Quinn Bear comes home in fourth. Leader of lap one will be the 23 of Billy Van Meter.
Van Meter leading the way. Recently picked up a victory. And the number 23 cars had a solid 2014 campaign, and he's building up his advantage to 4 car lengths over Atkinson. Craig running third. Fourth, Bear, and fifth, the 28 of top qualifier, Sean Amore.
Right behind Amore, a cluster of cars from 6 through 9 to 35. Current points leader, Greg Van Alst, the 83, J.P. Crafty, the 3rd. Here comes Thomas Leonard, Jared Adelman, Jason Taylor, right there as well, the 07, now the 96. 17-year-old Jared Thomas joins the pack. They head down the backstretch. Up front of them, battle for third, Quinn Bear looking to the inside of Trey Craig.
It is for the third position. Bear on the low side. It's Craig on the outside. Bear was very good in the warm-up session earlier today. They wiggle, they wobble, they get it through turn number 4. And they stay off of each other. No tire marks on these two cars. And it's third, fourth, and fifth. They're basically nose to tail. Bear taking another look to the low side of Craig.
Up front, Billy Van Meter, the 18-year-old from Indianapolis, Indiana, the Edco Welding Chevrolet out in front. Jason Atkinson, the all-time career wins leader. His CRA Late Model Sportsman Series competition running in the second spot. Trey Craig hanging on that final podium position. The 94 Quinn Bear is fourth. The 28-year-old Starforce fast qualifier Sean Amore running in the top 5.
Quentin Bear, the Avon, Indiana driver, a rookie with the series in 2014. Again, looking low. He may open the outside lane for the 28 of Amore and Barkas, who had those mechanical issues yesterday, again with problems. Brandon Barkas off the pace on the low side on the backstretch.
Tough break for Barkas, the Kendall Bell Indiana driver. Couldn't work in the course he needed to get that car repaired. Unfortunately, his afternoon over earlier than he planned. 5 laps completed, 35 laps to go that time by. Make it 6 laps completed this time. Billy Van Meter continues to show the way.
Starting to close on some slower traffic, the 21 of Larry Swinford out of Atlanta, Indiana. They'll be catching him over the next lap or two. Van Meter leading the way and continues to extend his advantage on the 7 of Atkinson. 3rd, 4th, and 5th. That's still one of the more heated battles in the field. We look to mid-pack, another one of the top point contenders this year. Dossie in car number 20, racing with last year's champion, Mark Lambert.
Van Meter gets by Larry Swinford to put him down a lap with 7 laps completed, 33 laps to go. Jason Atkinson also negotiates around the lap car. 3rd through 5th, still nose to tail. The 15 of Trey Craig, 94, Quinton Bear, 28 of Sean Amore. They'll head into 3 and 4.
Quinton Bear in the 94 got into the outside retaining wall on the exit of turn number 2. He skimmed the back straightaway wall. Car still seems to be running fine as he closes again on the 15 of Craig.
Bear right on the back bumper here. Winner here back in the spring. Trey Craig in the 15 machine. Craig, oh, what a save by Trey Craig. A little contact between him and Quinn Bear. Craig keeps it moving forward. They'll head to 3 and 4.
Definitely a little bit of contact using the chrome horn. The 94 of Bear looking to the outside of Craig now. He's got the room. Craig giving him the outside lane. He's going to be able to get around him on the front stretch. We'll see if Craig returns the favor. They head into the first corner. He will not. He will be able to catch him. Bear pulling away from Trey Craig. That Bear 94 is very around the 21 of Swinford cleanly.
Van Meter comes down the front stretch one more time. Catching up to the last car on the lead lap, the 17 of Gregory. As Van Meter comes out to number two. Oh, we got another battle going for the fourth spot. Trey Craig and Sean Amor trading some pain. As they'll head down the back stretch, Amor around the outside of Craig.
Trouble coming off turn four. Around goes the number one car. First caution of the afternoon. Cicero, Indiana driver Dave Duncan. Dave Duncan, the veteran driver in the Dad's Truck at Auto ConnorsCure.com Chevrolet, has spun on the exit of turn number four. Brings out our first caution of the afternoon. It is with 11 laps complete during this Reynolds Body Shop 40 at Lucas Oil Raceway.
Coughlin Cars pace car pulls on the pit road. It's in the hands of Billy Van Meter in the 23. Jason Atkins in the 7. They'll lead him out of turn four. Chase Sutter, Brian Nook in the green flag in hand. We're back underway.
Billy Van Meter back out front and into the lead. Van Meter back into the top spot. Falling in line in second is Atkinson. That worked out pretty nicely for him. Craig runs third, but after a few laps put on his tires, he really faded as he's able to move. You can see really sliding off the corner. They had some contact in this race. There might be more coming up.
As Quinn Bear looks to the inside of Trey Craig for that third spot, Sean Amor is in fifth. Craig Van Alst now sixth. Jared Thomas, a good run for him. The Jared Thomas Racing Ford sitting in the seventh spot. Thomas starting in 10th. Working on the back. Current race leader, Craig Van Alst.
Thomas, a young driver, a teenage competitor that's racing with us at Lucas Oil, and really didn't know much about him coming into this weekend, but he's so far turning some heads and running in our top 10, kind of looking toward the top five as he challenges the point leader, Greg Van Alst, turn three.
Up front, Billy Van Meter is your leader. 14 laps completed this time by, 26 laps to go. Jason Atkins in second.
Craig for a second time during this race. 15 laps will go on the board at the line this time for Billy Van Meter. His lead, not too big. 5-6 car lengths over the 7 of Jason Atkinson. You see some smoke starting to come from the 94 of Quinton Berry. I don't know whether it might be some tire smoke. He's had some contact a couple of times, so could be a fender down on a tire. That 94 of Bear, though, running strong. But definitely some smoke coming out of it.
And heading down pit road, stopping his pit stall. Tough break for Fort Wayne, Indiana's Tommy Cook. He is on pit road as the race continues. 16 laps completed, 24 laps to go. More and more smoke coming from the 94.
Pretty sure it's coming off the right rear. It looks like the right rear of Quinton Bear's car is where the smoke's coming from. And he did have some contact with the wall coming on the turn two area to the backstretch earlier in this race. Could have moved that over onto the tire. Could have moved the rear end around a little bit, too, on Quinton Bear's 94.
But it's not slowing him down. He's starting to move away in the top two machine. The 23 of Billy Van Meter, the 7 of Jason Atkinson. Go back behind Bear. The battle for fourth continues. The 15 of Trey Craig. The 28 of Sean Amor. They had battled before that first caution flag came out. Amor had got by him. Reverting back to the last depleted lap, put Craig back ahead.
Has to be frustrating, as you mentioned, for Amor, already passing Craig, and now mired behind him again, trying to be patient, but not wanting to give up too much ground to the top three cars. They're starting to build up a sizable lead, and Quinton Bear, who has been the fastest car on the track the last few laps, is still closing on our top two. I think if this stays green, it's going to heat up here in the next five laps.
We are approaching halfway here in the Reynolds Body Shop 40 for the Vore's Welding CRA Late Model Sportsman Series. Powered by Jags, 19 and 21 to go. Billy Van Meter has led the whole way so far. Jason Atkinson not letting him stray too far out in front. And Quinton Bear is closing the gap as they head into 3 and 4.
And also Van Meter has set up maybe going away a little bit here close to the halfway point. Atkinson reeling him back in, and the cross flag signifying halfway. 20 laps in, 20 laps to go in this Reynolds Body Shop 40 for the Vore's Welding CRA Late Model Sportsman.
The 23 Billy Van Meter is your leader. The 7 Jason Atkinson is second. 94 Quinton Bear is third. Go back to the 15 of Trey Craig. 26 of Jared Thomas now in the sixth spot. 35 of Greg Van Alstyne, 7. 24, Terry Fisher Jr. is 8. 8-11, Thomas Huffer Jr. Good run for him, running in the ninth spot. And rounding out the top 10, the 83 rookie competitor J.P. Crabtree, the third. Just outside the top 10, the 07, Jason Timmerman is 11. A good run for the 41 of Hunter Jack. And Jack now in the 12th spot. No trying to challenge Timmerman for 11th.
Closing on Quay Gregory, the 17 will move over to the low side, heading into the first corner. Get out of the way with 18 laps to go. It's clear racetrack ahead. You see Atkinson decides to put a move on here pretty soon. The 23 of Van Meter within two car lengths, as Van Meter maybe slowing a little bit from what we saw early in this race when he was able to build up his sizable advantage.
That's Van Meter.
Look out at 3 and 4. Sean Amore able to save it so far. Still on the throttle. Caution flag, though, coming out.
Wow, what a save by Sean Amore. The number 28 machine kept it moving forward, but the caution flag does come out. Wow, Adam, what a save by Amore.
Amore, I think, had some contact, didn't see what initiated. He and Trey Craig, I believe, were still racing with one another. Saw Amore in the middle of 3 and 4. I think I spotted him right before you did. And he was way sideways, stayed in the throttle hard so that the car wouldn't loop around and go up and slap the wall. When he did, he saved it, and he again had to save it once again coming off of 4. What a save, as you mentioned, Sean Amore in car 28. So Sean Amore in the 28 car, after a pit stop, will come back out onto the raceway. We saw him take a tire to the right side of that car, and Amore, the top qualifier, back to the racetrack on the turn 1 and 2 portion of the speedway. We've completed 22 of the scheduled 40 for this Reynolds Body Shop 40 lapper. Green flag set to go. Chief starter Brian Duncan ready to give him the green. Coming off of 4, Quentin Bear with problems in the 94. Up into the wall he goes, maybe a tire down.
Jack goes around, Rick Sullivan goes around, everyone taking evasive action. Quay Gregory was on the gas, into the piles, into the back end of your reigning series champion, Mark Lambert in the 18.
The Coughlin Cars pace car, 2-pit road once again, 22 complete, 18 to go. The Reynolds Body Shop 40 set for green.
And that green flag waves in the air. We're back at it one more time here. They are side by side going down the backstretch.
Atkinson, a strong run. That power underneath the hood of the number 7 pulls him back forward right at the end of the backstretch. But Van Meter, that momentum, so important in the outside lane. He will lead lap 23.
In the 96, started 10th. He is on the podium in third, the race of his life for the quarter midget graduate.
Thomas running right now in third, followed by Craig. It's Crabtree, who's had a great weekend so far in the 63 to the inside lane. Crabtree, the 83 car on the low side, the 24 on the outside. Fisher, hello, turns 1 and 2. And it's going to be Crabtree having the advantage for a moment, but Fisher fighting back in the second lane. The battle for fifth continues.
Crabtree is 6th, Greg Van Alstyne 7th, Thomas Huffer Jr. is 8th, 14-year-old Hunter Jack in the 9th spot. In the 41 machine, Chad Richardson started 18th. He's in the top 10 for the first time this afternoon. He's in 10th in the 62. Jason Timmerman shuffled back to 11th in the 07. He'll get back in the field. Jack Dawsey the 3rd, the number 20 machine, started 19th. He's in 12th.
Also watching is the 94 of Bear tries to make his way back through the field after a pit stop. Quentin Bear right now shown in 22nd position, working on Rick Sullivan, looking high, and now he drops back to the low side following the number 1. That's Dan Duncan.
But up front, it is Billy Van Meter, your leader. He looks in his rear mirror. He sees that familiar white number 7, Jason Atkinson, right on his back bumper, trying to fight with the 18-year-old Billy Van Meter as he heads to turns 1 and 2.
Closing on some slower traffic, 21 of Swenson will be going a lap down here within the next lap. They may catch him in 3 and 4. In fact, Swenson drives. drops off the pace. We'll move over to the low side as the lead duo will pass him in turn three. Van Meter leads. Atkinson second. Thomas third. Back with that two-car pack for third and fourth. Trey Craig still holding his own.
Battle for the fifth spot. The 24, Terry Fisher Jr. around the outside of J.P. Crabtree to third. Give fifth spot now to the Austin, Indiana veteran. A veteran of many roars, the ARCA Series Super Series, making a late model Sportsman start this weekend. Terry Fisher Jr. now to fifth as the laps continue to click off, this time by 29 laps completed, 11 to go for Billy Van Meter.
Again, Crabtree working on Fisher. It's Crabtree, I think, a little bit better through the corners, but just can't make the run on that inside lane. You see it rotates well, picks up a little bit of ground, but then on exit, that outside lane momentum. So we got one slow here on the front stretch. The 9-11 of R.J. Norton III has slowed. He should be able to make that left turn down into the infield right at the end of the front straightaway, and he will. Heating, you can see some water coming out of the overflow of the 9-11 of Norton.
Three quarters of the way through the Reynolds body shot, 40, 30 laps completed, 10 laps to go. Billy Van Meter here in the win at the Winchester Speedway in the CRA Late Model Sportsman Series competition on Labor Day, Monday, September 1st. He won himself a feature at Anderson Speedway a week ago yesterday, so he's on a pretty good roll.
Trouble in turns three and four. Sullivan backs it into the wall deep in turn three. The 21 of Swenson, the one that brings out the caution originally. Swenson, who has gone a lap down a little bit ago. Swinford, the Atlanta, Indiana driver, the Edco Welding Gitterbent Racing Chevrolet, has spun up in turns three and four. And Larry Swinford then collecting about a half a turn back the 20 of Sullivan. Was able to get it slowed down for the most part, but you can see the left rear of the 20 car of Sullivan pushed up toward the tire somewhat. Double file as the cars head off into turn number one. The Coghlan car's pace car again will exit in turn number three as Atkinson has had a couple of nice starts, and I think he might be strong enough now to hold off Van Meter. If he can clear him, Van Meter kind of takes him down the banking a little bit in turn three, tries to keep his momentum away, and it's going to be Van Meter off of turn number four to the green. And we are back. 10 to go to better start for Van Meter this time. In fact, he's going to pull ahead of Atkinson and bring Trey Craig along to the high lane.
Craig taking advantage of that outside second row starting spot to get by Jared Thomas. Now he'll challenge Jason Atkinson. Going into turns three and four, Atkinson making that inside lane work. This time by 9 laps to go. Billy Van Meter continues to show the way. Terry Fisher Jr. off the pace of the 24. He was running fifth.
And Fisher
has
a pretty nice run.
Billy
Fisher with a nice run going in the 24 car, running up around the top five for a good portion of this race, but the Indiana driver heads back to the infield, done for the day, at least in this series.
32 laps completed, 8 laps to go. The time is now for Jason Atkinson to show Billy Van Meter what he's got. Van Meter with one rear win in the CRA Indianapolis Sportsman Series. Jason Atkinson looking for the milestone win number 15 here at Lucas Oil Raceway. The 7 car now has 7 laps to do it when they come by the start-finish line.
Sean Amor, after restarting deep in the pack, all of a sudden in the top 10, Sean Amor, the top qualifier, as he picks up another spot at the line, working his way on the 62, heading down into the first and second turn. I'm telling you, Sean Amor, very stout race car right now.
Yes, he is working his way to the 8th spot as he gets by Chad Richardson, shoveled back to 9th. Behind Richardson is Hunter Jack in the 41. Jason Timmerman right there as well. Good battle, 8th, 9th, 10th, and 11th. Amor, Richardson, Jack, and Timmerman.
And up front, still the lead duo racing away from the pack. Going to be 5 more laps to go at the line this time. 5 circuits remaining for the 23 of Billy Van Meter.
5 to go this time. Billy Van Meter 5 laps away from his first win here at his home track, the Lucas Oil Raceway. Jason Atkinson, he's won here before. Circle City. Now he'll try to challenge Billy Van Meter coming out of turn number four.
Van Meter still holding a pretty wheel on the outside lane, but Atkinson on the inside looking low again. Down in one and two, has to check up to avoid contact as he kind of pushed up the banking in the middle of the first and second turn. That allows Van Meter to get away by a couple of car lengths. Atkinson, I think, will quickly close again.
Three laps remaining, this time by Billy Van Meter, trying to put some distance between himself and Jason Atkinson. They'll head into turns one and two once again. Distantly back in third is the 15 of Trey Craig. Fourth of 96 of Jared Thomas. Fifth spot, the 83 of JP Crabtree to third. But this time by, they're looking two laps to go. Billy Van Meter trying to hold off Jason Atkinson.
Atkinson going to get another chance. He's back to within a car length heading into the first corner, but will he be able to make the move? He's going to set it up. We've seen some great last lap battles in late model sportsman competition, including a year ago, and right now it's going to be Atkinson trying to get by the 23 of Van Meter. He's to within a car length now. White flag is out. One more to go.
One lap remaining for Billy Van Meter to try to hold off the all-time career winningest driver in CRA late model sportsman series history. They carefully get by the 33 of Steve Pearson to put him a lap down. They'll head down the backstretch one more time.
Van Meter enters turn three. Atkinson drops to the low side. Atkinson on the inside all the way to the bottom in turn number four. Brings it off sideways, but it's Billy Van Meter to the victory. The Edco Welding Lawrence Towing Chevrolet to his second win of the season. First repeat winner of 2014. By Jason Atkinson in the 7, finishing 3rd. The 15 of Trey Craig taking the 4th spot. Jared Thomas in the 96 and finishing 5th. J.P. Crabtree, good run for the 83. A lot of cars finishing this event. In fact, at the end of the race, we have 21 on the lead lap. So 21 of the 29 starters finishing this race on the lead lap. And right around 23 drivers finishing the race. So a pretty solid event. The late model sportsman back in action at the Winchester 400 race weekend a couple of weeks from now. See a lot of the same competitors, plus a few different ones, as our top five competitors pull to the front straightaway at Lucas Oil Raceway. The first event of the afternoon complete, the Reynolds Body Shop 40. For the Vore's Welding CRA late model sportsman, powered by Jakes here this afternoon.